we thought this would be a good time to chance to present to you a project that is being managed by the PSEN. So we'd like to give you information on what about this project and what we have done so far. The project's name is APEC Policy Tools. So I'm here to give you a little bit of a background. So this project, we call APEC Policy Tools project, was during the 2015 APEC hosting of the Philippines, where the Office of the President through the Presidential Management Staff and then the APEC 2015 National Organizing Council initiated the development of policy tools which were aimed at enhancing our capacity to craft responsive and evidence-based policy positions in APEC as well as in other fora. This project was developed to address the observation that knowledge is scattered across government agencies. So you have different agencies would have different concerns, different issues, or they would have different commitments or initiatives. And also, I'm not sure if you would notice, but during meetings, for instance, you have different set of representatives sometimes coming from different from the agencies. And also, when you have, say, government personnel transferring or leaving the offices or the agencies, then there's tendency to lose institutional memory. So the project was, the aim was to have a repository of APEC knowledge in government. So the objective is to gather relevant documents and reports and then synthesize them in an easily searchable and easy to use knowledge management system, which can be used and accessed by government agencies, and those information they can use in crafting policy positions, Philippine positions, again in the APEC, and then later on we'll expand to other fora like WTO and others. So I'm talking about the tools. So these are the set of database or information that is under this APEC Policy Tools project. So we have the APEC Policy Database, and this database is envisioned to be a user-friendly and easily searchable database of policy positions taken by the APEC members on key issues tackled in APEC. And then there's a Philippine Commitments Dashboard, which is a master list of Philippine commitments in APEC, and with the initial status of our compliance with each. And then the third one is the monitoring and evaluation tool for Philippine initiatives, which maps out the milestones necessary to translate the Philippine initiatives to concrete policies and programs. And so as I said, this was initiated by the APEC 2015 NOC. So when their mandate expired in 2015, someone had to continue the work. So the task to continue the project, to sustain the project, was given to PIDS. Some of the work includes developing the knowledge management system, refining and possibly expanding the tools into other international fora. And the task assignment given to PIDS was through a memorandum from the Executive Secretary of the Office of the President. This was in January 2016. PIDS was considered highly suitable because of its expertise in policy research and also being a governmenting tank, and because it is a member of the APEC Study Center, as you know already, PITS is hosting the PASEN. So the tools were officially turned over to PITS. We have the photos there. So in 2016, April 2016, we had this turnover ceremony with the PNS Undersecretary Ferdinand Cui and then President Dr. Gilbert Yanto, and then Dr. Erlinda Medalla, who was the PSN director then. And then we had also staff from the PMS and also PIDS, including Mela. So as so now we're here at PIDS. PSEN is currently managing the project, and so far we have I know there are TIBAM agencies here, but we have presented a first version of we developed this web portal where the data and information are all there. So we presented it last year in a TIBAM meeting, and we received comments, valuable comments from the agency representatives, and we also received strong support from Yusuke Hanky when he was leading the TIBAM at that time. And we also continually are receiving support from the APEC National Secretariat. So we're thankful for the assistance that they have been giving us. They're sharing with us reports and other information that we need for updating and improving the policy tools. So I guess I should stop here, because my colleague Mark will present the policy tools in detail.
So thank you, Mal. I'm going to present the website, the policy paper policy tools. So if you are going to go. If you're going to visit the PSEN website, there's a link for the policy tools. If you're going to link to enter the so this is basically the interface of the APV or the website. So there is a link for PSEN member studies and member login, and also for TIBAM member agencies. Now, if you are a member of TIBAM, you will be given, or you can log in, and or you will be given the access. So for you to have access on the three main tools for the databases, the APEC policy database, the MNE tool for the Philippine initiatives, and the Philippine commitments dashboard. It was made exclusive for TIBAM members because there might be issues or concerns that are sensitive and that should only be contained among the members, especially because this is a Philippine initiative, or there might be issues that are sensitive for other member economies. Right, so basically, what you can see in the APEC policy database are the different topics. In this case, what we have right now are the policies in 2015-18. So we still don't have the information for 2016-2017. Those are some of the things that we still need to update. And you can also see some of the projects in 2015. the PH treatments dashboard, these are the for every initiatives or priorities of APEC. There's an equivalent PH initiative, so we are where those are recorded here in the PH commitments dashboard. Then for the MLE, this is used to monitor the status of those projects and initiatives. Now we are currently updating the tool for it to include some more information, to make it more informative, and to make it more functional from the name itself, policy tool. So it really has to be functional and maybe can be used for analysis or research, make it more analytical, and to also enhance the look, to make it more attractive. Okay. So currently we are working on a new version. So this is how it looks. So we added some links for PSEN, for the APEC Trade Repository, APEC MSME Marketplace, for the Philippine National Trade Repository, Virtual Knowledge Center and Services. This is managed by AIM. And we also intend to include news or for the different events related to APEC. So if you are doing, for example, if you are we are trying, as I said, you are trying to enhance the book. So this is one thing that we added is for and also to make it more informative. If you are going to look to click the flags of the member economies, there is an additional information, trade and investment profile of each member economy. So we included that. And if you are going to click the link for the member economies, it will lead you to this interface. And each, if you are going to over those marks, it will also provide some information about the economy. So just basic information. Then again, if you have the logins already, you can also access the three main tools. And we are also trying to enhance the search engine capacity or capability or features of the different databases. And we also intend to enhance or to include some visualization and reporting tools, and also to include trade and investment database that will focus on APEC and other regional blocks, including ASEAN. But we have to consider that it should not duplicate some or existing databases. So one of the purpose also of presenting this to you is that APEC policy tool is a policy tool, so we need to intensify or strengthen our collaboration with our partners, especially the TPAMs, and maybe for the members of the PSEN. And one suggestion also is to have a focal person for each members, for each agency, especially for DPAM. And we are going to give, instead of signing up, we are going to give each agency one login detail or access what taxes for each agency. And we also want to ask you guys comments or suggestions on how we can improve further the policy tools, especially for those non-TIBAM members. So what do you want us to include for you also to make use of it, especially for your studies? And Ma'am Lin, a while ago, suggested or mentioned that it's good to have a database for the projects that we can use in APEC. So maybe we can also include that. Okay. So that's basically my presentation on AP. So anyone with, yes sir?
Mark, do you have statistics on trade and statistics between and amongst the
countries? As of now, we still don't have that, but that's one feature that we would like to add.
Go ahead. And recently, China had the first import symposium in Shanghai, right? Would you know which are the products to be bought by China from the Philippines? No information yet. Study,
yes,
or research on.
Yeah. Some more.
And issues. Are you going to include also issues, for example, the trade war?
Yes.
Between US and China? Points raised by them.
Yeah, we can also include. We are doing face by face enhancement. So that's actually maybe next week we can include that. Because I think that's really important, especially if we are going to make a policy.
Yes,
it has to be on
issues.
Does the database include studies done by the PSU? Can you go back?
Yeah.
Okay, you have links there. Right. Or this is only for the Philippines?
The APEC priorities and initiatives. There are projects from
the components.
Yeah.
Policy database, the commitments dashboard, and then the monitoring and evaluation.
If you are going to search one by one on all of those entries, there are mentions about DSB projects. Projects funded, as what mentioned in the earlier presentations. So there are.
So basically, this is in database is really just the repository of policies by individual APEC companies.
Mm-hmm.
For example, PSU studies done by PSU. Do you intend to do that, or is it for other avenues?
For projects, it's a PSU.
there was a, like, an information dissemination na came from a list of reports or I mean studies done by the PSU, and most of them are very useful. The recent one was on digital economy, everything related to digital economy, and I think a number of all of us could use that. Kasi it's APEC-wide, and it's very academic, no? Well, academic and policy-oriented. So that would be a good starting point. Even a little, siguro not really posting, kasi it's just replicating lang eh. Kasi accessible naman siya online. But
link.
Maybe a link, yeah.
Link,
what's
the website again?
It's APEC Policy Support Unit.
I want to add something. Like, if you will click the our virtual knowledge center, you will find the links also, which will be support to different events. Because it's like from Asian Institute of Myanmar, we are managing the virtual knowledge center on services. Just click the link, you will find the different links and studies which is related to trade and services. So you can, like, it's interlinked, you can find that there also.
Thank you. You're going.
Okay, thank you for that. For the PSU, they have, APEC has a database for all of the projects funded by APEC. So it's, I think the page commitments and initiatives. Some of those funded by APEC are in here, and some those self-funded initiatives are also listed or included in here. The domestic initiatives.
Are there any discussion forum on this policy tool? Like you have a comment box or discussion forum for this portal?
Discussion forum. We don't have it, but if you suggest, yes, maybe we can do it.
Because these are all initiatives like which is done in the Philippines, and I had a meeting with Nala and I told her that you should share your link with our portal also, Dana. You already mentioned here. So if you share the link, we have this comment discussion forum that can be linked both websites. Both websites it can be linked if someone has questions. Because the knowledge center, the virtual knowledge center is basically facilitating all the 21 economies. We are asking all 21 economies that they will share their links and they will be registered there. All the partners should be registered there. So anyone have a question with files, they can directly get the email from us and they can get the alert. So if I don't want that it will be duplication, but it's good if you have a comment box or suggestion or discussion forum. So you have a tab. Maybe I will ask that to add the link. I'm definitely asking them to register and add your links because we have no traffic. Because over portal is little bit different. We have to, first you have to register. A common person, academia, from government, from any profession who want to get information, they can register. First they have to register and then they can access to the information and they can use the uploaded material, even they can contact the person who already registered. So it's very nice, I see the initiative is very nice. Lot of material available here, but I think we need this, we need both portals, we need this comment.
We are going to consider that, sir. But again, as I mentioned earlier, we are protecting some information, so maybe we still have to.
Yeah.
So we're going to consider the
sure if you're immediately related dun sa presentation ni Mark. It's really more information dissemination. So like, really, you're sure you have questions on where to get death data on Philippines, China. There are existing databases kasi on trade. And even in APEC, they have this APEC trade repository. There you can get so many data on trade, investment, all those stuff. So type nyo lang, APEC trade repository, lalabas na yun. Another thing is, we have this for those MSMEs. We have this APEC MSME marketplace. There's a marketplace, so yung mga SMEs na would like to export, to venture, those things. So may tayong ganong database. And sa Philippines, we also have the Philippine, let's say you want to export, ano yung mga requirements ng agencies natin. We have this Philippine Trade Repository. Philippine National Trade Repository. So yun yung mga website, i-google nyo lang, lalabas na yung mga. So meron mga existing may link. Oh, yun nga. Yung, yeah, and also yun, yung kay Carwan, the virtual services. That one is different because it's APEC-wide.
Yeah.
So that's why all APEC economies contribute. But this particular project kasi is the Philippines. So we are, yun nga, as mentioned earlier by Mao, the agencies, the focal person, diba, there's change in administration, change of people who have that information, and then we go, and when they go, wala na yung information. So, we're trying to keep track of those. And I mentioned din kanina ni Ms. Lynn, na sana if we have this database on all the Philippine, notes, concept notes, so you will have a basis how to propose future. So, ito yun. So, that's why it's good that some of the TIBAM agencies are here. So, sana yung commitment nyo to contribute to this portal. Kasi initially, we're doing it. But later kasi, we cannot do it alone. So like, the regular updating, we do not attend the APEC meetings. The agencies, di ba, you report. Pag you attend kasi an APEC meeting, you're required to submit a one-pager, two-pager report through DFA. And as we all know, people in DFA come and go. And sometimes, yung documents nawawala. So that's why, whatever you submit to DFA, actually we're asking it from them to have for us to have a copy of it. And, but then, hindi lahat ng agencies nagsasubmit. So like, when we ask DFA, ano yung, let's say, SOG, kasi di ba, there are four meetings, so one, two, hanggang yan. Sino yung mga agencies na nagsubmit? Minsan, tatlo, dalawa, nakita nyo ang daming working group. So dun yung kailangan namin yung, we have this list of TIBAM agencies and the focal person of that agencies, but then hindi rin kasi siya yung umaattend. As you know, yung mga mechanics sa mga agencies. So siguro yun yung gusto namin na makuha, na commitment kung sino man yun, para yung updating na maano natin talaga, ma-keep track. Kasi like how many years tayo ulit yung mag-host? Then wala na naman tayong info, back to basics na naman. So yung, ito yung purpose ng policy ko. Thank you.
Okay.